Hey guys, it's David from mdbootstrap.com. Welcome to another tutorial. In this video, we're gonna learn how to achieve so-called infinite scroll effect. So if you look at this page, which is a Facebook feed page built with MDB5, have a look at the bottom of our page. So we have one post only, as you can see here. And we are about to hit the end of the page, and as soon as we hit the down of the page, we see the spinner and new posts are getting loaded. And when we hit bottom again, it will reload new post. So this is what we're gonna learn in this video. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so as a starting point, we're gonna use this template, and there are two ways to get this template. The first one is to navigate to mdbootstrap.com, go to Bootstrap 5 section, so MDB5, our newest UI kit, go to Lab, where you're gonna find all well-known projects like Airbnb, Gmail, Facebook, Instagram, and more recreated with MDB5. If you check Facebook newsfeed, you're gonna go to a project page where you're gonna find a source code including HTML and CSS of this layout, and you can obviously check its preview. You can also check it in a full screen mode to see how it looks on the full screen of your browser. So this is the starting point, and as I mentioned, this is the first way. You can also download this code to your computer, and this is the first option. Second option, which I strongly recommend to you, is to navigate to youtube.com/mdbootstrap.com. So find our YouTube channel, check for our videos, and find this video, build Facebook profile with MDB5. I'm gonna put the link into description down below, and if you check this video, you're gonna find the entire tutorial which explain to you step by step how to build this Facebook layout from scratch. And I strongly encourage you to do so, because that's gonna be fun, you will see. Now, one way or another, our starting point is this page with only single post. And now we're gonna learn how to add infinite scroll to it. Okay, so I have this starting template over here. Let me run it locally in the browser. Okay, so this is our template locally. Now let me close other stuff over here. We don't need that. And let's navigate to infinite scroll page. So once again, in order to find infinite scroll docs, you have to navigate to MDB5 version, which you can find over here, and then go to infinite scroll. Let me also tell you that infinite scroll is MDB Pro component, so you have to get MDB Pro in order to use it. Once you have it, download it, and it will be ready to use. So what we're gonna do, what MDB infinite scroll actually is, you already have seen. There are some more, there are a couple more examples over here. So as you can see, it's loading extra data once you reach the end of the page, depending on direction you choose. You can obviously work with asynchronous data, so you can call some external APIs to load data, and this is usually the use case. And we're gonna use, in our example, we're gonna use this example as a starting point. So here we have some posts, right, and it's loading some new post. If imagine that it was some blog or magazine, so we're gonna use this code over here. So let's get started. Now, we are not interested in HTML over here. Actually, we're gonna use just one thing from it. So we're gonna use spinner. So this is the spinner you can see over here. So this is the one. So let's get this spinner, and now let's jump back to our code. Now, within our code, there are plenty of code. So we have to find this post, this card. We're gonna multiply this card. So we are looking for Jane Doe. So we have newsfeed, and this is our This is our card. So let me collapse it. So this is our card. So we need two things. One thing is container. So in our case, this section is element which is containing elements like card. And I'm gonna give some ID to it. I'm gonna call it posts. So we need this wrapper with certain ID, and we have to paste this spinner over here. I'm gonna add text center class to center it. So this is our spinner. As you can see, by default, it has style display none, so it's invisible, and it only get visible once we reach the bottom of our page. Now let's move to JavaScript. So I'm gonna copy this piece of code and paste it into our JavaScript section. And let's quickly go through this code. So what we have here, we have two variables which are important for us. So one is already, we already know, it's posts. So this is linked to our container, and we also need to connect to our spinner. So we have these two elements. Then we have our items. So in this case, since we are using this example, in this example we have, as you can see, image, title, and description. So these are variables which we are which we're gonna update in our template. So we have a couple of elements over here. They have different images, title, and some text. And then we have a post template. So this is HTML template which we're gonna use, and obviously we're gonna replace it because currently this template corresponds with this, and we want obviously to load new cards. Actually, we can check how does it work right now. So let's try to do that. Let me save it and let's see how it works. So now you can see it's loading, but it's loading this new articles. So we're gonna fix it in a second. And then we have a piece of JavaScript which is taking care of verifying whether we scroll till the end of the page and calling certain functions to load and add new stuff onto our page. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to replace this template. So what I'm gonna do, let's get back to our original post. So I'm gonna use this as a template, but I'm gonna get rid of all these comments over here. We don't want them. I'm gonna remove them. So we will be basically multiplying this post, and we're gonna update author, text, and a picture. Obviously, in the real case scenario, we would add more data, more dynamic data, like this avatar, this time, number of likes, some comments, and so on. But for the sake of simplicity of this tutorial, we're gonna stick just to author, description, and image. So let's get here. Let me duplicate this one. Okay, so we have two cards now. Let me collapse the first one now, and let's work on that one. So obviously we want to have some margin top from the top here. So we want to have margin between first and the second card. Now what we have here, we have card body, we have our image, so that's cool. We want to leave this in our template. We want to leave description. We want to leave our media. And now we have card body. So here we have what we have here, 124 likes, comments. Okay, let's leave it. So these are reactions. Probably we will set it comments to zero because we're gonna remove them. And now what else we have here? So this is buttons, like, comment, share. Now we have input, so probably this is the comment input, write a comment. So we're gonna leave it. And we have answers. So now let's get rid of these answers. So we have the single answers here, which are comments, single comments. So let's get rid of that one. Let's save it. And now we have a template with just a picture, description, and input. So we're gonna use this hour as an input template. So let's get this card. I'm gonna cut it and let's paste it into our getPost template function. So I'm gonna paste it on top of that. And I'm gonna remove this one in a second, but first I'm gonna get this variable. So what's happening here in our template, this is gonna be replaced with this data which we have over here. So this is image, and obviously in the real case scenario this data would come from some API call. Okay, so let's get let's replace this picture here. So we want to have this post image. Now let's replace also post text. So we have it somewhere here, this description. Okay, and let's also get post title. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna change this post title to post author. So Jane Doe, let's change it to author. And let's replace it here. So we don't have title anymore, we're gonna change it to author, and let's change the content of this. So it's not, this is an article, but it's gonna be this. Let's call it new author. Okay, so we also have text, some lorem ipsum, so we're gonna leave it as it is. So we have new template over here and some old template. So I'm gonna get rid of this one, I'm gonna remove it and save it, and let's see if that works fine. So now we have the single post, original one with comments. Now scrolling down, yeah, we have few more posts. Yeah, and as you can see, the images are changing. Obviously we have new author. If we were to change this to something like author one, author 2, 3, 4, that would make it more visible that the data are actually dynamic. So let me quickly add it. So we have 8 new posts, and let's check again. Yeah, author 1, 2, 3. So now we can clearly see, I see last thing to fix, which is the scroll. It should have some margin. So let's search for spinner and let's add some margin top 3. And now it has nice margin from the last post. Okay guys, so that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you can see that with MDB you can build really, really advanced projects. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask them in the comments down below. Don't forget to join our Facebook group. And if you want to see more videos like that, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. We'll be right back.